This is what I call the shooting star effect in PowerPoint, and I'll show you how to make it. Step one is make the stars. Step two is spin the stars. And step three is add motion pads. Okay, let's begin. The shooting star actually consists of two separate stars that are layered on top of each other. The first is a 16-point star, though you can of course experiment with other types of stars. The second one I'm going to use is a 4-point star, and you can adjust the points to be fatter or skinnier as you like. Now let's color them in properly, starting with the 16-point star. Go to Format Shape, and let's remove the outline, so that's out of the way. Now go to Fill, Gradient, and make it a path gradient, and let's reduce it to just two colors. Make the inner color white. And now let's make the outer color white as well, but we'll make that one 100% transparent. And again, you can experiment with other colors as well, but I really like the white on black look. And let's just use a format painter to make our 4-point star match as well. And you can play around with how fat or thin the points are. And now we'll just layer one on top of the other so that they're exactly lined up. Okay, so now we're all set and ready for the next step of spinning the stars. For this, I'll just start by separating them again so you can see the difference in spins. The 4-point star will spin in the direction of the motion path, so I actually like to spin it clockwise. And just make it repeat until the end of the slide so it doesn't stop spinning. Now the 16-point star will spin in the opposite direction, so counterclockwise in my case, and also have it go up until the end of the slide here. Now we'll put them back on top of each other, and it actually looks better if the 16-point star is spinning twice as fast as the 4-point star. So we'll make the 16-point star spin at 1 second and the 4-point star spin at 2 seconds. And here's what it looks like. You can also make it go faster by making one of them 1 second and then the second one at a half second. And that's what we get here. And I know the quality isn't that great in this preview, but it'll look better when you actually try it out. Okay, well that's it for the spins. So now we're ready to add the motion pads. For this step, I'll just make the star smaller so you can see the motion a little bit better. Now I'll pull the stars to the side so they can go across the screen. And when adding motion pads, make sure you have both stars selected. And then go to the motion pads selection, and let's add a basic line for now. And just adjust these lines to go across. Make sure that both motion pads are lined up exactly on top of one another. Make it start with previous and slow it down a little bit. And here's what it looks like. Now for another example, let's remove those and we'll go in and this time we'll add a custom path. Draw it in how you'd like, slow it down, and here it is. You can see you can get that bouncing effect there. Okay, again, let's remove that path. And this time I'll show you how to make an angle. That is when you want to go straight in one direction and then straight in a different direction. For this, we'll start again with a line path. And let's have it go up and then drop down sort of in the middle of the screen. And again, line both paths up with each other. And now we'll actually repeat the process exactly so we get two more motion paths going down. But this time, we'll grab them and place them right underneath the first two and drag them down off the screen. Now make the first two start with previous and make the second two start immediately after them. And this is what you get. Okay, well that's basically it for how to do the shooting star effect. Thanks again for watching. Let me know what you think and see you again soon.